Hey guys, welcome to Builds. And today I'm working again on a nice, hot, beautiful summer day. But it's okay, because I'm working on my own truck today, so I don't mind taking my day off to work on my own stuff, because I don't get a lot of time to. So on the Silverado, or the Interceptor as I've named it, I want to update the front end a bit. It's just, I'm tired of it. First thing is, when I'm driving, it gets foggy around here sometimes, and just even at night, I want to upgrade the lighting. I just want more lighting on this thing. So we're going to be putting a rigid light behind the grille today. This grille won't really work because you can see, it's not going to allow light through. So we're also going to upgrade the front end with this. Big holes in the front, hopefully it's going to let a lot of light shine through, and it looks a little more sinister too. And I'm also having a little bit of issues with condensation building up in the headlight housing, so we're going to change those out as well and put new ones in.
Okay, so the first step is we have to remove this shroud sitting on top of all the cooling systems, like the radiator and everything. And what's holding them in is this. So how it works is, this piece goes in, and then this other piece will make it expand, holding it in. To remove it, we're just going to push out the top piece first, pull that out, and then you can go ahead and remove the other piece. You could remove from here, but you risk damaging it. It's designed to remove the inside piece first, to release it, and then take this out. Then we go ahead and remove the shroud.
Alright, so to remove this grille, it is a joke. There are no fasteners on this thing. It's just clipped right in.
Okay, so while we're still taking everything apart, let's keep on going. Let's put the lenses in first. Like I said, this thing is a joke to take apart. For the headlights, you have a little retaining clip right here, just a piece of metal. Pull that up, slide this out, and you can remove the housing. Now, keep in mind, because we're just doing a quick switch, I need to keep this up to make it easier to get the bottom housing. So we're going to be careful on these bulbs. So what I'm going to do is, I'm wearing latex gloves to make sure I don't get any oils on the bulbs. We're going to take the bulbs out right now, so we can keep on working on the truck.
Okay, and next we're going to bring out our other tool, a bigger flathead screwdriver. Just push that pin in. Pull this out. You Dodge guys must be hating me right now, and I know what I'm talking about. You saw me do that plow video on that 2012 Dodge Ram 2500. These are LEDs, so it's okay if you touch them a bit, but just for practice sake, I'm going to keep my gloves on. But yeah, those lights are a pain to take out. I'm pretty sure I can take apart this whole front end before someone gets their first headlight housing out of that truck. Okay, now we're ready to put in our new housings. The only main difference with this one is this marker here is not amber anymore, which is okay because my running lights are amber, so I still stay legal, but this gives it more of a cleaner look. I'm going to leave the protective film on during the whole install, just in case, that way I don't scratch the thing while I'm working on the truck. So again, it doesn't really matter if you touch these because these are LEDs, but just for a good practice, try not to. Keep in mind, some of these aftermarket
housings, the fitting's not that great sometimes. This one fit good, but you might have to modify the plugs for the lights sometimes, but in this case, we're lucky. And while I was replacing the housings, I just had the bulbs over here on the bench, just on a piece of paper towel, just to minimize any contamination on them. Okay, we're going to go install our headlight housing. So again, I'm going to leave the film on it. Another thing I want to mention is these come manufactured with a silicone bead around it. I've gone ahead again and taken some clear silicone, usually used for bathrooms because then you know it's waterproof, and it's not going to break down over time as nearly as much. So I've done a bead all the way around to help give us a better seal. So I'm just going to rest the headlight housing here and go ahead and install our headlight bulbs. Okay, so you guys saw me put together the driver's side headlight housing, and I just realized this. I'm going to show you the smarter way of putting these headlights back in. Take your headlight housing, I've already done this side on the high beams. Put the bulbs in first. Not just a hat rack now, is it? Now go ahead and plug in your plugs. And don't forget your retaining clip.
Okay. So far, so good, right? Pretty easy. Okay, on the plug stuff. The rigid light. Now, before we go on to how we're going to mount this, you might be looking at this truck, and if you have the same truck as me, you might be saying, that doesn't look anything like my truck. Which it doesn't. This right here, I had this made. I made a cardboard template, had my buddy all make it out of stainless steel. So what this does is it just protects all the condensers and the rad behind it. But what it allows me to do is it allows me to mount the light anywhere I want. Because there's stainless steel hardware, fits right through it. Okay, layout change. Remember that whole price tag of being foggy here and everything? Forget I said that. This will not be a good fog light by any means because it just sits too high. The only way to have a really good fog light is to sit really down low there. What I was hoping was to do a compromise and have it sit really low here in the grill and kind of line up with these lights. That's not going to work because if you've seen some of my pictures on Facebook and on the website, this truck actually runs a push bar on it. So what there is there's a bar right here. So if I had the light down here, it's probably just going to hit the bar. So I decided to opt and put it a lot higher in this application. So now we're just going to go ahead and put the grill back together. Okay, ready to put our grill in. It's a three-piece, goes in the exact same way, it's just going to clip right in. And then just got your two end pieces. Okay, so it's all blended back up together, so let's just turn on all the lights and see how it looks. I have not finished wiring up the light, but I got all the wiring under the hood so we can use our power probe to fire it right up. Good. Alright, so we're done wiring under the hood. Let's show you that real quick. So we got our Bosch relay here. It comes with a different style, but I had an extra Bosch relay, so I decided to use that, and I've screwed it into the rad support. All the wirings need to run. These rigid industry lights are really easy to wire up, actually. It already comes with a ring terminal, so you just go in the negative and positive of your battery. It has a fuse and everything, too. And then you go ahead and just run it along, preferably all the factory wiring, and then run through your firewall. So for the switch, I've gone ahead and put in the dash here. This is usually where the push button selector goes for the four-wheel drive. This truck's a two-wheel drive, or you guys that have the floor selector, this is probably just going to be an open pocket. So I've gone ahead and made a panel of ABS plastic, and then mounted my switch in there. Then I have the option to add more switches as I go along in time. The other thing I also changed up was the switch itself. It comes with a illuminated switch. I didn't like that, so I just went with a standard toggle flush mount switch. Okay guys, so we're going to do a test. I guess you want to see what it looks like. So here's it with the parking lights on. Can't really see anything. Regular headlights.
Now we're adding on the rigid and the high beams. And this is it just with the rigid by itself. So not bad for being behind the grille on a stock looking truck. So we're gonna do a little drive test just so you guys can see what's going on with it. This is just it with the lights on. These trucks have an automatic light sensor, so the headlights will turn on no matter what when it's dark. And then we're gonna hit the driving lights now for the rigid. So it just adds a little more lighting. The way it's aimed, it's not so, you're not gonna blind people. That's how I have it set up. And then if you want even more light, we're just gonna add on the high beams. So it does a pretty good job, I think, for like a stock looking truck and have this much light. I did rewire the front lights so when the high beams turn on, the low beams stay on. So I got a lot more light going on. But it throws it pretty far. Low beams off, rigid off. I probably have to play with the headlight aiming just a bit. It's throwing it a bit low, but I'm pretty happy with the rigid. You can't really tell on camera, but I can see pretty far right now. And a lot of my friends that run HIDs, this is pretty much as good, if not better in some ways, because these housings were actually designed to hold halogens. A lot of my friends have HIDs, but they're in a halogen housing. They're not really designed for it. And it is really bright, but the light just goes everywhere. But yeah, I'm pretty happy with this. Okay, I want to show you guys another little example here. There's a sign up there. You can't really see it. Now I'm going to hit the rigid right now. Now you can see the rigid's reflecting light off that sign. I'm going to turn it off again. See way back there on the screen? You can't really see it. Now with the rigid, lights it up. So it is throwing quite a bit of light through that grille. And then with your high beams, it just makes it way better. So all the lights working together definitely makes a big difference on this truck.
Today's product we installed was the Rigid Industries SR Series light bar.